Praise the Lord. Good. Tell you what, we got a lot to pray about. I want you to be praying for the Jimmy Kirby family. Amen. He passed away. Amen. Need to be praying for them. Amen. That God comfort them. Amen. He was my longtime friend. Amen. He was a buddy to me. I just hated to hear that about him. Amen. But we need to pray for his family. Amen. That God will be with them.
Comfort them.
And comfort them. Also remember Cookie Simmons. She's at home. She's resting. Amen. And I hope that she had time to talk to the Lord while she was there. Amen. Because you don't, like I said, you don't know when the last call is going to be made. You lose your life.
Nobody
you not have time to talk to him. She remember Cassie. The doctor told her she had double pneumonia today. And so pray for her. Remember Dawn Marie.
She's running a fever,
but she's got two hernias that they're going to have to work on. See, go in there, try to do something. Amen. She asked for prayer, so remember her. Also remember Misty.
Walking.
She's sick.
She's got the walking pneumonia. She's sick tonight, so remember her. Also remember Brother Danny Patrick tonight. Amen. In your prayers. Also remember the pastor at Westland Church over here on Columbia Avenue.
Ronnie and Pat Hamilton.
They were in a bad wreck today. Amen. They had to fly them out.
My neighbor sent me a message a while ago. They made it up there and said that Pat is doing pretty good. It's her sister. And Ronnie's in ICU. That he's got a broken pelvis. And where they had to give him blood, his blood pressure started to go low. And they're going to do surgery on his pelvis. They'll fix all that. And said that he was back in praising the Lord.
Amen. Remember that. Amen. I was praying for him. I was praying, Lord, take, don't let her have blood bravely. Lord, stop it. Lord, let him. He'll be all right. So remember that today, tonight. Amen. Also remember Wendell, Bonnie's daddy. Amen. I reckon he's home now. Amen. He's back home. Amen. Remember her mama, Jackie. Amen. In your prayers. Also remember
Darlene
tonight. She's not feeling good. Remember her. Amen. Remember the church. Amen. When the church is alive, the devil wants to fight. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just going to go on for the Lord regardless. Amen. We've done it before. We can do it again. Amen. We can win the battle. Amen. Because the battle's not ours, says the Lord. Amen. It belongs to him. Little David said, "This battle's not mine, but it belongs to the Lord." Amen. God will fight your battle. Amen. So remember that. Also remember Brother Timmy Brown, Sister Tammy tonight. Amen. In your prayers, God touch her. Brother Jackie Stamps tonight. Remember him. Amen. And his wife, Sister Pat. Also remember Sister Kathy. Her asthma is real, real bad. I seen her today. I helped her get the car seats fixed. And she got the kids put some new car seats in so they can't get out. I locked them in good. They couldn't get it undone. They was like, "Pa, you got us locked in." I said, "Oh, well, you ain't going to get out now." The cop done told them, said, if we pull her over, y'all going to get a ticket. We're going to take y'all to jail. Oh, they was like, "But they won't." But she got them some new seats, so we got them in there and got them locked in. But she needs prayer. She's got asthma real bad. In this time of the year is when it really hits her a lot, bronchitis. Amen. So remember her in prayer. Also remember Nora's sister Wilma. In your prayer to her family. In your prayers, remember my nephew, Matthew Todd. His daddy asked us last night, sent us a text, and said, "Would y'all remember Matthew in your prayers? He's on drugs real bad. He's got an addiction, and he needs to be set free." Amen. So remember that. We told him we'd put him in our prayer box tonight, so one of y'all write that down. Amen. We'll put him in the prayer box. Amen. Also remember Nora's brother, Brad. Amen. Remember Stevie and Jenna, they're in Florida. Just be coming home, amen, this weekend. Our landlord from the church here, he's in Florida. Amen. Pray that God, they'll probably be down there for a while. But pray that God keep his hand upon them, bring them back safely. Amen. Pray for the United States of America. Pray for this land and country. Amen. Because listen, it's getting evil. Remember all those that got shot up there in Maine? Amen. Those that survived and those that didn't. Last night they were telling this, they were telling that. And then today they said only 13 got killed. Amen. So it's better than 22. But you know how some medias are. They like to raise the thing up before they even get their answers. But remember those families, because there's a lot of little children, I believe, got shot too, because it was a little league, little children's league, bowling league at the bowling alley. So remember those families, amen, in your prayers. Remember Sister Fairclough, her two daughters, she wants to see them saved. Amen. Remember Brother Bob Sandlin and his family. Amen. Anybody else got a prayer request?
My family
and all my lost loved ones, and continue to remember everybody that's on TikTok. Yes. And
remember my neighbor, too,
you know,
sister,
brother-in-law, and all my lost loved ones. Yes, amen. Remember Betsy there on TikTok. Amen. I don't know if she's watching tonight or not, but remember her family. Remember her. Amen. Remember Angela Bell, her family. Amen. She really does need prayers. She needs our prayers. Amen. Remember that. Remember those that was on the prayer line Tuesday night that gave their prayer requests in. Remember those tonight. Amen. Somebody else.
Remember Jeff Sossman. He is recuperating from a stroke. Remember Tim McClellan. He's recuperating from a stroke. Remember all my loved ones. Remember my overall health. Remember the local churches. Some of the local churches of people's battling COVID again. So remember all of them and remember all my lost loved ones.
Yes, amen. Also remember Pastor Ryan. He's not doing. He had some tests he hadn't have done and it wasn't good results, but pray for him that everything will be all right. I think it's to do with his eyes.
He had to have some eye procedures.
He has to have some eye procedures done. Amen. So remember him. Amen. He's Brother Randall, Sister Tasha, and I remember them. And in your prayers, remember remember Brian Kirby. I know it's going to be hard on him. You know, it's hard when you lose a loved one. It's hard. Amen. Remember Sharon Turner tonight also.
Sister Bessie said to tell you and Sister Moore hi.
Amen. Well, hi back. Amen. Anybody else before we pray?
Remember my brother Rusty, because he was pretty close to the guy, Timmy Kirby, that passed away. Him and Rusty had been friends for over 40 years. To remember my brother, Rusty.
Yes. Amen. Remember Brother Morris. I think he's supposed to start to go back to work, wasn't he? Praise the Lord. Amen. That full time?
No, but that's the next, probably the next day, not Monday.
Okay.
They don't do orientations on Monday.
Pray, keep on praying, amen. Keep on praying. Remember that, amen. Also remember Sister Connie, she's sick. So remember them tonight. Amen. Remember Sister Teresa and Brother Gary and Sister Charlotte. I don't know what's wrong with them. I don't know if they're sick or
couldn't make it,
amen. So remember them. They might be going on vacation. Remember Brother Johnny? He said that right now he's been trying to get his work and stuff done because the cold weather's supposed to start coming in. When it comes in, he can't do blacktop or asphalt. And he said also that they've been going back and forth down to Alabama with the baby, trying to help Charity with the baby. But he said he was coming back. They're still gonna come, amen. So just remember that family, remember them in prayer. He does a lot of traveling. He's working now. I think he's working in Tennessee somewhere right now. So pray that everything will go all right and he'll get done tonight and come home safely. Most of the time when he gets home, he has to turn around and go to Alabama. So pray for him that God will watch over him, protect him. Amen. Also remember the service tonight. Pray for each and every one that sings. Pray for your lost loved ones. I'm praying for my lost loved ones. I got a lot of lost loved ones I want to see saved. Amen. Unspoken request, by the raising of your hands, pray that you see and pray to the altar. Bless you, Lord God. As we come to you tonight, we thank you, Lord God, for that opportunity to give you to us. Lord, that you allowed us to wake up, Lord, to see another beautiful day, Lord, outside today. Lord, and you just blessed us last night, Lord. Lord, this morning, God, about 3:30, God, we were outside and taking the pictures, Lord God, and how you blessed us, Lord. How we felt your presence outside, Lord God. Just felt that anointing, Lord God, just on the walls, Lord God. hope. Praise the Lord. You mean this, Brother Michael, come up and take us to the top. You mean you have God laid on your heart and he'll bless you.
Grace, Heavenly Father, we come to you right now, Lord. Give you praise, glory, and honor for another beautiful day you've given us to come to your house to worship you, Lord. Also, dear Lord, we ask you please bless this offering. Please bless those that have been given, equally those that do not, Lord. Also, dear Lord, we ask that you please use this offering for the uplifting of your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise
thank
God.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. I love that song, but this is the Lord's house. Everybody's welcome. Amen. We need to realize, amen, that everybody, amen, is welcome in the house of God. There's a lot of churches won't welcome people in the house of God. Amen. But we're supposed to welcome them into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
You can't feed them if you don't welcome them in.
Amen.
Amen. You can't teach them the word of God if you don't get them in here. Yep. Amen. The Bible said that whosoever will, let them come. Amen. And drink of this water of life freely. He didn't say, amen, you had to smell good, you had to look good, you had to be rich. Amen. He said, whosoever. That means anybody. Amen. That means the poor. That means the bum. That means the drug addict. That means the alcoholic. Amen. That means the homosexuals, the lesbians. Amen.
Homeless too.
The homeless.
The rich.
Amen. The rich. He didn't leave nobody out. Amen. Whosoever will. Amen. It's good to be in God's house tonight. Amen. Have Brother Michael come start us off tonight. Amen.
Daniel Cameron's.
You want me?
Yeah.
All right, good.
Don't you worry.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you need freedom, saving, he's
He's a prince of shaking savior. You got chains. He's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. There's a better life.
Oh,
God saw me, and he knew
I'm In a prison and throw and said,
is a liar.
Yes, he is. Amen.
And the father of it. Amen.
Amen.
Listen. Amen. He thought he was going to take my voice out. Then he bottle of water fell over.
Amen.
With the lid on it and spilled out everywhere.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, help us, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I want to talk just a little while. Just a few minutes. Amen. What we need in the day and hour that we're living in.
Lord Jesus,
hallelujah. Amen. What day and hour is that, Brother Miller? It's day and hour of the coming of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. You got your Bibles, turn to Titus. Titus chapter 1. Amen. Titus chapter 1. Amen. Titus chapter 1. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know, the enemy would not more like to try to stop people from serving God.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says in Titus chapter 1 and verse 1, it said, Paul, a servant of God, apostle of Jesus Christ, according to the faith of God's elect, and the knowledge of the truth, which is after godliness, in hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world and before the world began, but has in due time manifested his word through preaching. Ain't you glad that he manifests his word through the preaching of the gospel?
Amen.
He said, which is committed unto me according to the commandments of God our Savior. To Titus, my own son, after the common faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. For this cause, I thee in the crate, that thou shouldest set in the order of the of things that are
wanting
in order
ordained
elders in every city as I have appointed thee. If any be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful
children,
not accused of
riot
or unruly. I looked up the word unruly. Amen. And we don't need people like that.
No.
We don't need no unruly preachers.
No.
Amen. We don't need unruly preachers. Amen. We got too many of them right now. Hallelujah. Amen. The definition of unruly, all right. Lack of discipline,
yeah.
Or incapable for discipline. Don't want somebody to discipline.
Right.
Amen. You got preachers. Amen. Amen. They don't want nobody to tell them. Amen. Hey, you got to do this. You're doing something wrong.
Right.
Amen. If God can't discipline us, amen, then something's wrong. Amen. In the Bible, if you read the Bible, God always sent a prophet to go and tell somebody, hey, you done something wrong. Amen. Listen to what he said in verse number
six.
If any man be blameless,
if any
be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused of rioting or unruly. For the bishop must be blameless as a steward of God, not self-willing, not soon to anger, not to give to wine, no, striker, not given to filthy lucre, but of lovers of hope, of hospitality, lovers of good men, sober, just holy, temperate, holding fast the faithful words as he has been taught, that he may be able by the sound doctrine both to
exhort
and to
convince
the gainsayers. Right, who's the gainsayers? The ones that don't want to listen. Got to be able to convince them by the word of God, by the preaching of the word. For there are many
unruly
and vain talkers
and
deceivers, especially they of the circumcision, whose mouth must be stopped, whose
subvert
whole house, teaching things which they ought not for filthy lucre's sake. One of themselves, even a prophet of their own sin.
The Cretans
are always liars, evil beasts,
slow
believing,
bellies.
These witnesses is true, wherefore rebuke them sharply, that they may be sound in faith, not giving heed to Jewish fables
and commandments
of men that turn from the truth. Unto the pure, all things are pure, but unto them that are defiled
and unbelieving
is nothing pure. But even their minds and their conscience
is defiled.
They profess that they know God, but in works they deny him, being
abominable
and disobedient, and unto every good works
reprobate.
Number 7. For a bishop must be blameless as a steward of God, not self-willing, not soon to anger, not to give to wine, not to strike, not no striker,
not given to
filthy lucre, but a lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just holy, and temperate, holding fast the faithful words as he has been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision. Amen, Brother Morris. I was driving going to Walmart, and I sent a text and I asked Brother Wayne if he wanted to preach early.
Yeah.
Never got no message back from him. Never did he read it. I saw where he read it. Never did get a message. Never did get nothing. Amen. So I went to Walmart, and as I was going to Walmart, I was over on Donley Drive. And I said, Lord, I need something tonight. Give me something. I need something. Amen. And you know what come to me? We need our spirit field preachers,
yes,
to teach us right from wrong.
Yes, we do.
And I said, okay, Lord, I've got that.
If we don't have the Spirit-filled preachers teaching us right from wrong, amen, then what are we doing? Amen, we're doing just like the Bible said right here. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision. Amen, they're too busy, amen, to doing their own thing. Amen, they're too busy worrying about the filthy lure, which is money.
Help him, Lord.
They're not worried about people's soul. They're not worried about being Spirit-filled.
Nope.
They're not worried about being anointing.
Nope.
Amen. All they worry about is prosperity.
Help
me,
Lord.
And then you got people that all they worry about is sticking their nose, amen, in somebody else's business, and they don't need to.
Come on now.
Amen. You need to get your own nose in your own business, amen, and get close to God and pray and ask God. He said, I'm coming after those that's made their self ready. He's coming after a Spirit-filled church.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
right.
Amen.
He's not coming back after a nosy church.
No.
Help him, Lord.
He's not coming back after a nosy person, a vain talker. But he's coming back after those that are Spirit-filled.
Help him, Lord.
Those that's ready to go to be with Jesus.
Help him, Lord.
You know what's wrong today? Amen. We got people, amen, they want to tell, oh, you just got to be so good. Mm-hmm. God's all about love, and he just loves you so much. And he just wants you to have all the good things of the world's got to offer you. He wants you to go out here and get you a good old bottle of beer and sit and drink it. He ain't going to tell you not to do that. Amen. I just read it to you. That in order to be a bishop, amen, you can't be able to do those things. Amen. You can't do those things. To be a pastor, you can't do those things.
Right.
To be an evangelist, you can't do those things.
Right.
You can't be a vain talker. Amen. You can't put other people down. Amen. You got to read the Word of God.
Amen.
Right.
Being a Christian, you can't do them things. Amen.
To be a child of God.
Do them things.
Amen. You can't do those things. People say, well, Brother Miller, I don't understand it. I don't either. I just go by what God speaks to me.
Right. Help
them,
Lord.
Sister Bonnie, that song come to me. We need our Spirit-filled preachers to teach us right from wrong. We need some old-fashioned seekers who'll pray all night long. We need some good gospel singers to help us go another mile. The church will triumph and go home a little while. You know what, Brother Michael? Amen. If we get back to that point right there, if we get back to being under the anointing of God, get back to being Spirit-filled preachers, amen, quit being prosperity preachers, quit trying to take filthy lucre from people, amen, quit trying to get revival so you can get offerings up, amen, let God give you a revival, let God send you on a revival. You don't have to go knock on the pastor's door and say, can I preach? You don't have to go to the church and say, can I preach? Amen, God will speak to that pastor, amen, and God will put him on your heart, amen, and he can get a hold of you and have you to come. But you got them all they think, boy, all it is go out here and preach. Get an offering, amen. The offering tonight probably went up about $5, $6. A lot of evangelists wouldn't even take it because they'd be, that ain't enough. You mean to tell me I spent my whole day studying, I spent my whole time preaching tonight, and all I got was $5 in the offering? Uh-oh. See, that's what they want, Sister Bonnie. They ain't worried about amen, seeing somebody saved. They ain't worried about seeing somebody set free and delivered. They're not worried, Brother Morrison, about seeing a drug addict delivered from drugs. Amen. They're not worried about that alcoholic getting that bottle out of his hand. They're not worried about that homeless person being able to come into the house of the Lord and see it. All they're worried about is trying to run them out of the house. Amen. I welcomed them in here last Sunday night. I told them, come on in, sit with us. But the devil can't sit under the presence of the Lord.
Yep.
He can't sit under it. Sister Bonnie, I say, Lord, I said, you said for us to be in season and out. I say, God, I need something. I need something today. God, just put something in my spirit. Just put something there. And all of a sudden, I hadn't even got past, I just had turned on Donnie Drive. Sister Bonnie and I had just got by the brake place right there, and the Lord spoke to me. You need our spirit-filled preachers.
To teach us right
from wrong. They're not teaching them from right from wrong now, Brother Morris. Amen. They're telling them that they can go out here and live any way they want to. Amen. They're telling them that they can go out here and shack up. They're telling them they can go out here and smoke pot. They're telling them they can go out here and drink a beer. It's not going to hurt them. Amen. They can go out here and run around on their wives. It's all right. They done it in the Bible. David got forgiveness for it. Hey, they're not teaching them the right way. They're not teaching them the right words. The Bible said to teach them wrong. The Bible said, amen, he said, for there are many humble, unruly, and vain talkers and deceivers. Well, they're deceiving people right and left. Brother Morris, they're telling them, amen, if you'll send me $1,000, I'll give you a word from God. Amen. They'll say, if you'll give me that $1,000, well, now, wait a minute. Now, the Lord spoke to me and said, you got to give me $2,000, and then I'll be able to give you that word from God. Amen. And it just keeps going on until it gets about $5,000. Amen. Then he's ready to give you a word from the Lord. And you know what he says? The Bible said, give, and it shall be given unto you.
Amen. That's all they stop at that.
That's all they do.
They stop at that.
They don't go no further.
Don't read those scriptures.
You take 10 people, get $5,000. Look how much money that preacher just made.
Money.
It's money.
That's what they're preaching for. A lot of them. Mm-hmm. Money.
I sat and I watched these videos and I watched these young preachers out there and they're going around and they're saying they're prophets. I'm prophet so-and-so. There's a black guy out there. I can't remember what his name. He said, but I'm a prophet. And I can look at you and I can tell. And I can look at a heavy set woman and I can tell her she's got back problems.
Well, of course, anybody heavy set's got back problems.
I can look at a woman, if she's got a big bust, she's going to have back problems. Amen. And that's what they look at.
That's a common thing.
Amen. And then they'll look, see how big of a pocketbook they carry.
Right.
Well, that's why your arms hurt. I can see it in the, in the spirit. Amen. They're teaching falsely.
Amen.
You got bishops behind the pulpit. Amen. And thinks they can twerk their way out.
Yeah,
my wife can. As old as she is, she can still twerk that thing. As old as she is, that's what Bishop T.D. Jakes did. Mm-hmm. Out there with his bebop shorts on, out there trying to bebop and shaking his booty all over the stage. Yeah, that's the kind he's talking about.
Mm-hmm.
That's the kind of man that needs to get back to the Spirit. They need to get back preaching the truth and quit trying to act like the world and quit trying to be like the world. Amen. Because he's going to be left behind if they don't change their ways.
Amen.
Quit paying your money.
Tyler Perry, one of the biggest hypocrites I ever laid eyes on.
Help him, Lord.
Brother Miller, you ain't supposed to do that. Why not? Amen. You can't cuss and try to speak in the Holy Ghost. It don't work.
Mm-hmm.
It don't work. Amen. You can't play a woman, amen, be able to dress up like a woman and think you got the Holy Ghost, because it don't happen. It don't work. It won't dwell in an unclean temple. Well, Brother Miller, he's just making a movie. He's just been, no, he's blaspheming. He's making fun of the Holy Ghost. Making fun. A mockery out of it. But they eat it up. This church world is eating it up. Well, he can cuss, and why can't we cuss? He can dress like a woman, why can't we dress like a woman?
Amen. Because they're not reading the word for themselves.
Why? Why can't we do it? Amen. Because there's not enough spirit-filled preachers out there anymore preaching the truth. There's not enough spirit-filled preachers, amen, that's willing to stand behind the pulpit if there ain't but one or two people in the church and preach, amen, just like I'm doing right now. Amen. The Bible said preach, amen. He didn't tell me, amen, that I had to have a house full to preach. He said feed those that's with among you. Feed them. They need to be ate. They need to be fed. Amen. They need to know the word. Amen. They need to know what Titus is saying. Amen. What Paul was saying there. Amen. He said a bishop, amen, better be ready. Amen. A bishop better be clean. A bishop better be holy. A bishop better not be angry. Amen. A bishop better be quiet.
That's right.
Help him, Lord.
A bishop, amen, better be lovers of hospitality. A lot of bishops, amen, won't let people come into the church because of the way they're dressed. A lot of them says you ain't coming in here because you smell. You ain't had a bath in 3 or 4 days. You ain't coming in here. A lot of them let them, Brother Morse, meet them at the door and say, you're not welcome. Then a lot of them let them come in, and because they watch them do things in the church, they're ready to throw them out the door instead of welcome them in and say, hey, sit here and listen to the word of God.
Teach them
about Jesus. Teach them. Amen. But they're ready to cut them down. They're ready to put them out. Paul said here, he said, if any be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful children. A lot of people ain't got a lot of faithful children. A lot of them, amen, their children are out here on drugs. Their children are out here and doing sex, making movies. And they think it's okay. They'll back them up, get out here and get pregnant. Oh, my little Susie got pregnant. Oh, we're going to be a grandparent, but we didn't know it was going to be this way, but we're just going to love her anyway. Come on, little Johnny got little Betty pregnant. Now, little Johnny, he's just gonna have to understand now that little Betty's mama ain't gonna let him be around her now because he done something he shouldn't have done. But now I can't hold that against him. I was young when I was like that.
Help him, Lord.
See, the Bible said, amen, that you gotta be able to have your children faithful. Not accusing of routing, what we see all now. What do we see them out there doing? Rioting.
Yeah.
Amen. It's supposed to be church people and their kids out there. Oh, my kid won't never do that. My kid's so good. Oh, he's just so, oh, my, she just won't do that. And you see them on TV and they're in there doing everything else. They're in there just stealing stuff out of the stores. Amen. They're going around knocking people over, hitting people, doing whatever they want. Amen. And mamas and daddies supposed to be going to church on Sundays. Amen. And they can't even keep their kids under control. There's something wrong. Amen. Because Paul was telling us, amen, you got to be able to control your children. Amen. 13, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 year old. They're under your care. Until they turn 18, and then they're under the world's care. But as long as they're at your house, you're supposed to be responsible.
Right?
If you're a man of God and you're a woman of God, I'm talking about a Christian, a one that goes to church and sings in the choir, one that testifies, one that teaches Sunday school, and you let your kids go out there and do that, and you don't do nothing about it, shame on you.
Exactly.
What are you teaching them?
that it's okay to go out here and steal when the Bible said thou shalt not steal. When they go out here and hit somebody over the head with a ball bat, thou shalt not kill. What do you teach them? Vain talking. Vain talkers. Cuss you out in a minute.
Right.
Won't even think nothing about it. Be in the store and hear them cussing their parents out right in the store. Mm-hmm. 8 and 9 years old kids.
Slapping them.
Little kids smacking their mamas. Tell them to go to H.
Help him, Lord.
What the Bible says, that they're all going to be there one day if they don't change their ways. Mm-hmm. But they use it in the wrong language.
Help him, Lord.
Man, I was out there at Walmart one night, and this boy, 9 years old, about 19 years old, he was calling his mama a B. He was calling her everything. Brother Morris, I wanted to smack his mouth so hard. I wanted to go get a bar of soap like I used to have to do, put a bar of soap in his mouth. Talking to his mama like that.
He'd have probably cussed you.
You ain't getting it. When you blankety blank, I will get it. She said, you're not getting it. And I wanted just to smack you and say, listen here, boy. Your mama said no. She said, I don't know what's making him do that. That woman interested, quit giving in to him. You're the boss. He's not. How many of you ever watched that Christmas story?
Yeah.
And that little boy was cussing, beating that boy to death. What did his mama do? She stuck a bar of soap in his mouth. How many of y'all remember doing that?
Yeah.
I do. Amen. One day, Mama told me, go get some strawberries. I went to pick strawberries, and I brought them back, and I was taking the tops off of them. Nobody around. I didn't think nobody was around. But more side, I just heard my uncle's name cussing. I didn't know what. I didn't know it was cussing. Brother Michael, I was only 8 or 9 years old. I didn't really know what I was doing. But I was really popping them tops off them strawberries. And my hands was getting ready. You ever done strawberries? You get them old seeds, they'll get in your fingers, and they'll hurt, and your hands turn. And I started saying them words that my uncles were saying. I didn't think nobody was real. Man, about that time, I felt somebody grab me by the nap of my shirt, right back of my head, pull me up. She said, what do you think you're doing? I said, I'm doing these strawberries for you. She said, what do you think you were saying? I said, she said, come here. She took me in there and put that bar of soap in my mouth. Man, I learned not to say it no more, Brother Morris. Because when my daddy got home, I didn't have a bar of soap.
Right.
Hey, man, I got taken care of real good.
Got the lawnmower.
You learned not to say
I learned not to say those words.
Real quick.
Amen. That's what's wrong now. The government tells you can't hit your kid because, amen, we'll put you in jail. You can't whoop them. Amen. The Bible said, beat them, it ain't going to kill them. God said, if you spare the rod, you spoil them. Amen. You make them spoil. Amen. That's what's wrong with preachers today. Amen. They're sparing the rod. Amen. And they got a bunch of spoiled congregation. Amen. They ain't doing right. They ain't living right. Amen. And they're listening to what the preacher tells them to do. Instead of living what God says to do. Amen, that's what they're doing. Brother Michael. Amen, they won't take correction. Amen, they won't take correction. But God showed us there in the Bible, he said, if you spare the rod, you'll spoil the child. Read on over in there, and he said that my people are spoiled. Why? Because they think that they can get by with everything, and then they're getting by with it. Because the preacher says it's all right. They're spoiling them. Petting them on the back. Putting a bottle in their mouth. When they need to be off the bottle and be on the meat. And the preacher can't even preach about the meat because he's too busy being on the bottle.
Yeah.
Right?
And I'm not talking about the baby bottle.
Bottle of the word.
He said, for a bishop must be blameless. as the stewardess of God. Not self-willingly.
As the steward of
God. As the steward of God.
Not self-willed.
Not self-willed. Not soon to anger. Not to give to wine.
Not given to wine.
Not given to wine.
No striker.
No striker.
Not given to filthy.
Not lucre. Given to filthy lucre. Huh.
But a lover of hospitality.
But a lover of hospitality.
A lover of good.
Amen.
Men sober. Just
holy. Hallelujah. You know what a striker is? Everybody think, oh, that's a cigarette. No.
Mm-hmm.
It's sex. A womanizer. A pimp. Well, God don't talk like that. Well, you ain't reading the Bible. A womanizer. And a pimp. What is preachers doing today? They're womanizers and then they're pimps.
Pulpit pimps.
Pulpit pimps, exactly. And God spoke to me today, just as plain as day, that song into my mind. He said, I need my spirit-filled preacher to teach them right from wrong. To teach them right from wrong. Need some good old-fashioned seekers. Who's in? That's supposed to be the church people. It's supposed to be seekers.
Amen.
That'll pray all night long.
Yeah.
Right?
Teach them to read the word for their self.
Amen. Need some good gospel singers because there ain't a lot of good ones out there anymore.
They're in it for the money.
They're in it for the money, the filthy lucre. Boy, we need some of them good old-fashioned gospel singers. Them good old Holy Ghost filled ones. Them ones that's been Holy Ghost filled. I'm talking from the head to the bottom of their shoes. With the fire of God. Amen. And they wear the clothes that they're supposed to wear.
Amen.
Amen. And they get out there and they're not singing for money, but they're out there singing to see souls saved.
Right.
I remember the Hensons came out with a song. Amen. Just to see a soul saved. That's what it's all about. I came to see a soul saved.
Ain't that what it's all about?
Yes, it Amen. That's what it's about. Amen. He said, when you're down in the valley, prayer is all I can do. Oh, I didn't see. When you're down in the valley,
Oh.
in his name. And hour that we're living in now, we gotta tell him it's wrong, it's wrong. It's right, it's right. Say him, what's wrong with living right? What's wrong with telling somebody that they can't live in sin and still think they can go to heaven? It don't work.
Need some good gospel singing to help us go another mile. The church will triumph and go home in a little while.
Hallelujah.
It'll be worth it after all. Hallelujah. It'll be worth it after all.
Congregation, lest ye die, it shall be a statue forever throughout your generation. Now that's Leviticus 10 and 9. They say, well, we're not, we can drink. No, the Bible says, do not drink wine nor strong drink. You drink beer, you're drinking strong drink. You drink wine, you're drinking strong drink.
Right.
You drink a shot of Jack Daniels, you're drinking strong drink.
Right. Anything fermented.
Amen. Anything that's fermented, you're drinking strong drink.
Amen.
This is the Bible. This is not me, but in Leviticus 10 and 9, do not drink wine nor strong drink.
Amen.
Thou nor thy sons with thee. When ye go into the tabernacle of the congregation, lest ye die, it shall be a statue forever throughout your generation. Your sons. Pastors going out drinking with them at the Mexican restaurants.
Tell them it's okay.
That it's all right.
That's where
preachers having beer parties and saying it's all right.
Amen.
Having football parties at the Super Bowl and drinking their little champagne and wine and says it's all right. But the Bible plainly tells you in Leviticus chapter 10 and verse 9, and I thank the Holy Ghost, do not drink. If I can get that across to somebody tonight on live stream, do not drink. I don't care what preacher tells you it's okay.
Read the Bible.
I'll tell you what
the
Word of God says. It's in Leviticus chapter 10 and verse 9. Do not drink wine nor strong drink, thou nor thy sons. In other words, not even with your congregation.
Right.
Don't go to their house and drink a wine cooler with them. Don't go to the house and drink a Bud Light with them.
No.
Don't go to the Dove Awards and drink your champagne with them. That's why I said we need our spirit-filled gospel singers back.
Amen. You need our spirit-filled preachers.
We need our spirit-filled preachers.
And you need to teach people to read that Word of God for theirself. Don't take somebody's word for it. Read it for yourself. And work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, rightly dividing the word of truth. Read it for yourself. Don't let people tell you this and that. Read it for yourself to know what you're supposed to do and not do.
The Bible says, but a lover of hospitality, a lover of good, not of bad. Amen.
Sober. What sober mean? That means not be drunk.
Amen.
Don't be drinking. Be sober. Just holy temperance. Holding fast the faithful word as he has been taught, that he may be able by the sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers. Amen. Let's see what gainsayers. One who consecrate or dismisses what is.
One who contradicts or denies what is alleged or opposer. A person who gainsays others, a disagreeable person. Somebody that's trying to make you think that you're in the wrong.
Well, glory.
Mine says the opposition.
That's what a gainsayer
is. Opposition.
The opposition.
They try to change the truth. They try to speak against you because you're preaching the truth.
And that's right? What falls back to reading the word for yourself.
You got to read the word of God for yourself and understand what the word of God says. James 1:26 says, if any man among you seem to be religious and bridled not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain. Uh-oh. Vain talker. That's what he's talking about. If you can't keep your mouth shut, don't open it.
Right.
Keep it bridled. Amen. Don't say a word. You shouldn't be saying a word. You should be listening. Amen. Being taught. See, Paul had to teach him there. He was teaching his own son. Teaching him. Titus, he was teaching him. This is what we got to do. This is how we got to live.
Amen.
We got to be blameless. We got to be holy. We can't be tempered. We can't be unruly. We can't be a drunkard. Amen. We can't be given into wine. Amen. We can't be having this many wives. Amen. He said we've got to be the husband of one wife.
Ruling
your children.
Yeah.
And your own house. This is the word of God. That's why he said we need our spirit-filled preachers to begin to preach the word of God. If it hurts them, it hurts them. If they don't like it, don't worry about it. Keep preaching the gospel.
And teach them to preach for themselves.
People don't realize he's coming back after those that's made themselves ready. With no sin, Michael.
Right.
No sin at all. And when you don't have somebody to teach them, and they're getting taught false doctrine and not sound doctrine, and it's not doing them no good. They're hearing vain talkers. Amen. They're hearing those vain talkers.
The word says to work out their own salvation.
You know what the Bible tells us?
They need to read it and understand it.
In 1 Timothy 6 and 5, it says, pervert, disputing, of men of corrupt minds and dispute of the truth, supposing that they gain is godliness from such withdraw themselves. They don't want godliness. They want to withdraw themselves from God. They don't want what God's got for them. They don't really want what God's got, because if they did, they would change the way they live. They would change the way they talk. They would quit asking for money all the time.
Right?
They'll get on TV and say, well, I just don't know. I read in the Bible and I found out that we've done wrong, and we just got to apologize for it, and we want to make everybody that we're sorry that we done this, and we're sorry we done that. And the next day they're on TV and they're asking for the money again after they're apologizing.
Yeah.
Cliff O'Dollar got on there after being here and done all his little crying, boo-hooing, and apologizing. Cliff O'Dollar got on there and he said, we just all found out that, we've been telling people wrong all this time, that it's what you can give that God will bless you for. And now listen, the next thing you know, he's on there saying, now listen, if you can give 100, give it 100. God will bless you. Well, that ain't letting God tell you what to give. Back on there doing it again. But now they had to make herself try to look good. Vain talkers. Filthy lugers. Mm-hmm. Robbers. Pimps behind the pulpit. The Bible said that. Brother Michael, he said they're filthy lugers. I told you what filthy lugers. I told you what striker meant.
Right.
Womanizers. One of the biggest one out there is a womanizer. And everybody thinks he's the greatest thing there was.
T.D. Jakes.
On TVN, he got his own TV show, and he's got this, and he's got that. And a newswoman come up to him, I don't know what's his name, but a newswoman come up to him and said, "We got you on video where you were with this other woman. And you're out here telling people that they got to do this, they got to do it. And here you out here cheating around on your wife and him cussing her. And him supposed to be a man of God and him cussing her. Mm-hmm. Telling her get off his property."
That's where the anger comes in.
That's where the anger came in. Amen. He told her he'd do what he wanted to do. Well, she didn't know what she got him on video. We got your video here. We'll show it to you. Not only did they have him with just one, they had him with more than one. Then you got one on there that's out there, not mentioning no names, but he's out there watching porno. Showing it to the little kids in the church, making everything look like it's all right. Not teaching them. And that's what he's trying to get back. What he's trying to get back to is those that will preach under the Spirit of God, Spirit-filled preachers.
Amen.
That will preach the word and tell them that what's right and what's wrong.
And tell them to read it.
Sin will separate you from God.
Take you farther
than you want to. Sin will take you farther than you want to go.
Right.
Brother Michael, it'll keep you longer than you want to be kept.
Right.
Yep.
A lot of preachers just quit. Gave up their churches and quit preaching for another woman or another man. Singers just gave up singing for another woman or another man.
Amen.
Singers now are just swapping just like it ain't nothing.
It's a common thing now.
It's just a common thing now. It's just a...
Everybody doing it.
Everybody's doing it. We'll just join the bandwagon. We'll do it too. A lot of preachers say, "Well, looky there, they've done it. Why can't I do it?" They're still preaching. They're still singing.
They don't fear God anymore.
They don't have people preaching the truth to them anymore.
They don't fear God like they need to.
They don't like to hear the truth being preached. They don't like that the Bible says that no liars will have their party, will have their part in the lake of fire. They don't like to hear you say that drunkards ain't going to enter into heaven. They don't like it when you say adulterers are not going to make it to heaven. They don't like it when you say fornicators are not going to make it to heaven. They don't like it when you talk about chastening. They don't like it when you start talking about
lining up to the word
of God. They don't like it when you say lasciviousness and all those sins. And they don't like it when you start preaching on sowing discord. They don't like it when you preach on gossip. And they don't like it, amen, because you're preaching on sin. The Bible said that's what we're supposed to do.
Yeah.
Right.
Is preach on the sin. S-I-N is what God said for us to do. I will tell people tonight, I appreciate y'all. We love y'all. I just done what God showed me to do today. I'm just dumb enough to do what God tells me to do. Amen. I'm just dumb enough, Brother Morris, to do what God tells me to do.
I've always had a place to sleep.
Amen. You make your dress right.
right. It'll make you talk right.
God,
amen. It'll clean your refrigerator up. It'll clean your TV up. It'll clean your videos up. I can preach you what God gives me, and it's up to you. Like Paul said, it's up to you if you want to live it.
Take it in.
If you want to take it in. Amen. We can't make you eat it. We can't make you drink it.
We can't make you live it.
And we can't make you live it. It takes you if you want to live it. But we appreciate y'all. We love you. We ask you please tune us back in Sunday morning. Lord's will. Amen. We'll try our best to be here. Get it going. Get ready. Amen. We got a lot of sick out right now. Amen. Ain't nobody got the COVID. Thank God.
It's that time of year.
Amen. It's just the changing of the season.
Changing of the weather. Amen.
But listen, I want you to know, we love y'all from the bottom of our hearts. We want to see you get right with God. That's why we preach what we preach. We just preach the true word of God. Nothing but the word of God. Don't add to it. We just preach what God says. Amen. When I pray and I ask God to give me something, he always winds up giving me something most of the time, Brother Michael.
Right. If it ain't but just a thought that he puts in my head. Mm-hmm. Well, how does he talk to you? He puts thoughts in my head. He
talks to you in the Word. And
he talks to me through the Word of God. Then sometimes if he wants my attention, he'll get it. Amen. But we appreciate you. We love you. Big old live, we appreciate y'all. We love you. Facebook Live, please. YouTube, we appreciate y'all. Please tune us back in Sunday morning at 11 o'clock. May God bless you is our prayers from He's Like Community Church.